UgoBuy is an associate professor of computer science, originally from Milan, Italy. His research interests are in modeling and analysis of concurrent and real-time systems. He has investigated various analysis methods using such models as finite automata and Petri nets. Additional interests include mobile app development and fraud detection in social networks. He's received numerous teaching honors, including the Award for Excellence in Teaching from UIC and the Harold A. Simon Award from the College of Engineering. Donald Bergh is an adjunct associate professor in the School of Design. He currently leads two senior-level graphic design courses, interdisciplinary product development and professional practice mobile application design. Don has also served as design director of the McKinsey Quarterly, design director at eLab, and design and publications director at Chicago's Museum of Contemporary Art. Don is an integral member of UIC's Innovation Center and is the co-leader of the Caterpillar Research Lab. We will begin with Ugo.
As you heard, I hail from Milan, Italy, where I studied classics in high school and then electrical engineering at Politecnico di Milano. I received my graduate degrees in Massachusetts, where I became interested in computer science. I've been working in the Innovation Center for the past 5 years. I'm not the only Politecnico alumnus here. Recently, I ran into Marco Susani, who was in my freshman engineering class at Politecnico many years ago. It was nice to find a fellow Milan freshman at UIC after so many years. This perhaps means that all roads lead not to Rome, but to the UIC Innovation Center instead. My journey at UIC started in 1990 in the former Department of Electrical Engineering and Computer Science. My research has dealt with concurrent and real-time systems. In these systems, multiple tasks execute in parallel, making software development quite challenging. When do these tasks get in each other's way? And what are the consequences? In extreme cases, concurrency can lead to mutual blocking of tasks in a way similar to gridlock in Chicago's busy streets. With funding from such agencies as NSF and NIST, I studied mathematical models and analysis methods for enhancing the reliability of these systems. I'm also interested in detecting deception in social networks, focusing on gender and location. To my surprise, with doctoral student Jalal Alouibdi, we discovered that one can reasonably guess people's gender from the colors that they choose for their social network profiles. Were you able to guess which son goes with each swatch? My involvement in the Innovation Center and its director, Peter Fenner, began as a co-teacher in the interdisciplinary product development curriculum and then as a co-director of the Caterpillar Lab with Don Bergh. The Apd curriculum consists of a two-semester course sequence sponsored by a corporation, which provides a problem statement for the students to work on. Each course sequence is co-taught by faculty from three colleges, namely Art and Design, Business Administration, and Engineering. Student enrollments vary between 25 and 45 students from the various disciplines involved. Typically, students are arranged in multidisciplinary teams of 6 or 7 students. The students are introduced to the innovation curriculum, which consists of research, followed by ideation, followed by prototyping. In addition, students gain exposure to different disciplines. They must learn quickly how to bridge cultural and language gaps across disciplines. The value to sponsor companies is the ability to leverage the creativity of fresh minds, free of the shackles of corporate culture, to their problems of interest. This approach often leads to significant breakthroughs. Caterpillar first sponsored the course sequence in the 15-16 academic year. The prototypes produced by our students were well received by Caterpillar. Caterpillar decided to continue sponsoring two new course sequences in the past two academic years and provided additional funds to start an innovation lab within the Innovation Center, which Don Bergh and I co-direct. Don and I are grateful for the generous funding. Weeks ago, the lab has moved to a new, larger space, as Don will discuss.
I'm less exotic than Ugo. I migrated south from Minnesota. I've been an adjunct here for the past 17 years with the School of Design. My non-academic work is varied and includes museums, ethnographic research firms, McKinsey & Company, and a startup called IOTA, which leveraged the Internet of Things. One of the reasons I teach here is my varied background. I have competence in a wide variety of domains, and this is what I try to teach my students. You don't need to be an expert, but you need to be curious and participate in a variety of things, from human-centered research to data analytics to storytelling. We started the Cat Lab with a short set of goals. It needs to be a place to develop, refine, and apply research methods. Students need to have access to users at the coal face. It needs to bring together technology with human-centered problems. And finally, a place for cross-university collaboration. Let me give you some examples. In a 45-year career, 1 in 200 construction workers will be killed, and the second leading cause of death is being struck by something. Our research suggested we need to shift the reception of alerts to the ground worker, and we developed a method to alert only those in the path of danger, eliminating false alerts. We're now designing the reception method, a set of haptics and LEDs that are worn by the ground worker. We field tested these in a series of rapid prototypes to measure the effectiveness in real-world conditions. It's evolving into a smart hard hat, which has not seen a redesign in about 60 years. Cat also asked us to look at the share economy. We determined that equipment operators are what needed to be shared. High demand by employers is met by word-of-mouth hiring on the supply side. We created a platform enabling operators to prove expertise with machine data. Students gain exposure to large-scale problems that Cat's customers face. One of the world's largest construction companies faces the daily problem of finding and refueling hundreds of machines scattered over a 40-mile site. This summer, our teams did ride-alongs with fuel delivery drivers in Texas to understand the demands they face. Our solution was a simple digital tool that helps locate machines, prioritize routes, and measure fuel dispense, saving hundreds of thousands of dollars on one site alone. We're working on another project now, how to keep the fewest pieces of equipment on the site and get them where they need to be. We also perform research that pursues technological insight. Cat asked us what we might learn from instrumenting machines with accelerometers. We're mapping patterns for a wide variety of machine activity, from detecting theft to measuring productivity. The university has provided us with about 2,500 square feet across the hall, and this reflects the commitment shown by both the university and Caterpillar. We're going to continue building the practice of innovation and help Cat shift their perception in the market from iron to digital.